Hello everyone, today I'm going to teach you grammars chapter number 3, that is parts of speech. Before proceeding towards the chapter or a video, I would like to tell you that I have divided this video into two parts. Why I have divided this video into two parts, you will be coming to know about this in the upcoming slides. If you like this video, then do this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get all my videos notification, and share this video with your family and friends too. So let's get started. First of all, I would like to tell you the content of the chapter. In this chapter, I will be telling you the definition of parts of speech. I will be telling you how many parts of speech are there with the help of the definition and the examples. And we will be looking around the solved exercise of parts of speech. What is part of speech? What do you mean by parts of speech? The words are divided into different kind according to their use or work in the sentence are known as parts of speech. Okay, as we read many sentences in our day-to-day life, while speaking those sentences, the words which we use for the completion of the sentences plays a different role, and these words are known as the parts of speech. Moving towards the next point, there are 8 parts of speech. First is noun, second pronoun, third adjective, fourth verb, fifth adverb, sixth preposition, seventh conjunction, eighth interjection. Among these 8 parts of speech, I will be telling you only the 4 parts of speech in this video, and another 4 parts of speech I will be telling you in another video. So let's get started. Here I would like to tell you the first part of speech, that is noun. Okay, noun is the name of person, place, animal or a thing. Noun are the naming words of person, place, animal or a thing. For the more clearance, let's see the examples. In the first sentence, the first sentence is the sun rises in the east. The sun rises in the east. In this sentence, sun and east are the noun. Here, sun is the noun of thing and east is the noun of place. Moving towards the next sentence, Kolkata is on the Hooghly River. In this sentence, Kolkata and Hooghly River will be our noun. Kolkata will be the noun of place and Hooghly River will be the noun of name. Moving towards the next sentence, Ram is a brave boy. In this sentence, Ram and boy will be our noun. Ram will be the noun of name and boy will be the simple noun. Moving towards the next slide, what do you mean by pronoun? Pronoun is a word used in the place of noun. Pronoun are the words which can be used at the place of noun. For example, okay, if you have to write any essay on your best friend, on your teacher, so in that essay you won't have to write the name of your teacher again and again, or you won't have to write the name of your best friend again and again. Instead of their name, you can write he or she. He and she are the pronoun. For the more clearance, let's see the examples of the pronoun. In this, Johan is a boy. Johan is a boy, full stop. He studies in our school. In this sentence, Johan will be the noun and the word replacing Johan will be the pronoun, and that is he. Moving towards the next sentence, Ria is a girl, full stop, everyone likes her. In this sentence, Ria is our noun and her will be the pronoun, because here word her is replacing the noun, that Ria. Instead of Ria, we are here writing her. Moving towards the next sentence, in this sentence, Mick is our noun and he will be our pronoun. Mick loves to study, full stop, he is good at skating. So, here the word he is replacing the noun Mick. Moving towards the next slide. What do you mean by adjective? What do you mean by adjective? Adjective is a word that says more about a noun or a pronoun. Adjective is a word, we can say that, which tells us more and more about the noun and the pronoun. For the more clearance, let's see the examples of the adjective. First sentence is, Ram is a brave boy. In this sentence, brave will be our adjective because it is telling us the quality of the noun. It is telling us the quality of Ram. Moving towards the next sentence, Neha is a clever girl. In this sentence, clever will be our adjective because it is telling us, it is showing us that how Neha is. So here Neha will be our noun. Moving towards the next sentence, Chirag is a nice boy. In this sentence, nice will be our adjective because it is telling us the quality of the noun, and our noun is Chirag. Moving towards the next slide, what do you mean by verb? What verb is? A verb is used to express action or a state. The main verb is to express the action or a state shown by the subject or the done by the subject. For the more clearance, let's move towards the example. We saw a movie. In this sentence, we will be our subject and saw will be our verb, as it is telling us that what we saw. Humne kya dekha? Moving towards the next sentence, you typed a few letters. In this sentence, typed will be our verb. Typed will be our verb, and it is telling. It is showing the action done by you. Moving towards the next sentence, they watched a cricket match. In this sentence, watch will be our verb, and as it is telling what action is being done. Now, moving towards the oral exercise of parts of speech. In this exercise, you are given different parts of speech irrespective to their statement in the bracket. So now let's get started. She went to the market and bought some eggs. And in the bracket, verb is given. Verb is written. So what you have to do is, you have to underline verb in the sentence. In the sentence, verb will be went and bought. Okay. What Sorry, that was a difficult question. In this sentence, you have to underline adjective as shown in the bracket. So our adjective will be difficult. Moving towards the next sentence, Johan is my best friend. In this sentence, you have to underline noun according to the word given in the bracket. So our noun will be Johan. Okay, moving towards the next sentence, Ram and Shyam are best friends. Full stop, they study in same class. In this sentence, we have to underline pronoun as shown in the bracket. So instead of study, our pronoun will be they, and they is used for the plural one. So wait for part 2, I will be uploading it very soon. Thank you for watching my video. Like, share, comment and subscribe.